It's not right or wrong to have one personality or the other, and it's not feminine or unfeminine. It's all in the way you use your personality and how God created you to nurture others, to bless others, and to nurture your own spirit.
Men, if you want to be more masculine, just drink black coffee.
That's your tip of the day?
More masculine.
All right, everybody. Hello and welcome back to my channel. My name is Caitlin and I run the blog called Mrs. Midwest. If you've been here before, I am giving you your warm welcome back to the feminine family. To anyone who is new to the channel or merely stopping by, we are all giving you a very warm welcome. If you are familiar with my channel, you know that we discuss topics relating to femininity quite frequently, and today is no different. Since I began my channel, I have been receiving this one question over and over. So today I thought it was time to finally answer the question, how can we be feminine when we have a big personality? Now, I think there's a few reasons a bunch of you have asked this question, and I do think they're valid. But today, before we dive in, I really want you all to know it is possible to be feminine with a big personality. Now, this question does make a lot of sense because the concept of femininity is often tied in with caricatures of kind, sweet, serene, gentle women. Think Snow White, Cinderella. Any type of sweet, gentle soul is often described as very feminine. Because of this, I think a lot of our big personality sisters can feel out of place in the femininity movement. They wonder, how can I fit in with femininity when I don't display those obvious feminine personality traits? The traits of being quiet, gentle, meek, and serene are feminine. They are, because those traits are often seen as very nurturing. But today I want to share with you all the fact that you can still have a nurturing spirit with a big personality, but that feminine nurturing spirit will be displayed in a different way. Now follow me through this next point. When I spoke about masculine men in my video on masculinity, I spoke about the fact that there is a general obvious version of a masculine man, one who is a leader, brash, bold, confident, outspoken, etc. But there are other ways for men to display their masculinity that might not be in that brash leader kind of way. Men who are quiet, men who are more thoughtful, men who like to work with their hands and not say much can all be masculine as well. Likewise, with femininity, we do have that very obvious example of that sweet, gentle Cinderella personality. But it doesn't mean that louder, bolder, sassier women can't be feminine, because those traits can also be nurturing. As I've spoken about so many times before in this channel, the concept of being nurturing isn't only about loving and being sweet and gentle. Nurturing something also takes a little bit of pizzazz and work and discipline. And because of that, I do think that a woman with a big, strong personality can be nurturing. As we've outlined on this channel, being feminine is about being nurturing, creative, beautifying the world around you, and tending to things. But you can do that with a big personality. It's just going to look different than that Cinderella archetype. I think things can get confused here because women with big personalities might not feel like they fit into that category of being gentle or sweet or quiet, which is femininity. The thing is, you can have quiet women who can be unhealthy in their personality, just as you can have big, loud personalities that can be unhealthy as well. For example, just because a woman is more introverted or quiet doesn't necessarily mean she's nurturing those around her. She could display traits such as being gloomy, cut off from other people, overly anxious, overly focused on herself, and ultimately unable to nurture others. Likewise, you can have an unhealthy version of a big personality, someone who seeks to suck all the attention in the room towards themselves, or someone who seeks to control others or hurt others with their words or their big personality. But the thing is, whether you're quiet or whether you're loud, you could be a healthy or unhealthy version of that personality. I myself can be very introverted, and when I fall into an unhealthy streak, it's usually when I can become overly gloomy, cut myself off from others, and fail to seek relationships. Likewise, a woman with a big personality could smother those around her. She could make everything about herself, or she could potentially hurt others with her words and outspoken attitude. It's not right or wrong to have one personality or the other, and it's not feminine or unfeminine. It's all in the way you use your personality and how God created you to nurture others, to bless others, and to nurture your own spirit. Now, the feminine spirit is about nurturing others and being receptive and welcoming. Big personality women can absolutely embody these traits through their sugar and spice and everything nice. I have so many very feminine, big personality women who constantly foster connections with the people around them, bring the party, start creative endeavors, and in general, nurture the people around them. They're not quiet spirits, but they're still feminine in the way that they seek to bless others and to grow themselves. Big personality women can often bring out the best in other people. They can start conversations and foster hospitality. All of these things are feminine. The fact is that a big personality is kind of like a superpower. Just like a quiet personality has its strengths, a big personality has its as well. You should never use your big personality to dominate others, to control others, or to even hurt other people. Women with big personality often seek excellence or intensity in their lives. Maybe they're extremely organized or they love being around people and having fun. Any of these things can be used in a positive way to nurture others. You can also temper your big personality to make sure you're not overly dominating others, hurting others, etc. Key with a big personality is to resist the urge to dominate everything around you. Having a fiery spirit is absolutely exciting and often needed in our world, but it's important to know the boundaries of when to enact some boundaries with other people and when to respect others. It's never good to focus on dominating other people, and this could be in things as simple as conversation, attention seeking, etc. Temper your big personality by focusing your energy and incredible gifts towards life-giving activities, nurturing other people, or working on projects. Don't use your big personality to dominate other people or to seek all the attention towards yourself. It's essential that we have a variety of women in our world. If you're not naturally meek or quiet, don't force yourself to be that way in the name of femininity. Instead, hone in on what makes you an individual and work on guiding that energy, guiding that personality towards nurturing pursuits. Above all, being feminine is about being welcoming. When you use your big personality, you can absolutely use it to be welcoming to those around you. Even as quiet women must nurture their personalities to potentially fight laziness or antisocial behaviors, big personality women have their battles to fight as well. No one is perfect. I have written about this before on my blog, but it is very clear in scripture that God has created a variety of women. Scripture highlights so many different women with many different personalities. Have Mary, the mother of Jesus, who had a very pure, gentle, and quiet personality, but we also have women highlighted in the Bible, like Deborah, who was a judge of Israel, or even Miriam, the sister of Moses, who helped lead the people. We have Esther, who went before the king to plead for her people, even though she could have died. Big personality women can be godly and Christ-like. Women don't all need to have the same personality. We're not created that way, and God doesn't expect that of us. The key is to make sure you're using your big personality to bless others, as I've said so many times in this video. Use your strength to support others and, by extension, nurture others. If you have an intense personality that seeks excellence and loves projects, use those projects to bless other people and to nurture your own hobbies. Don't worry or believe you can't be feminine because of your natural personality. Instead, hone in your natural gifts and how you're created in a feminine way to bless other people and to bless yourself. Celebrate your differences and understand that God did not create all women to be the same, and femininity can be displayed in so many different ways. All feminine women do have some things in common in the sense that they are welcoming, nurturing, they seek to create in their life, and they seek to beautify things in their life. Hi, Harley. There's a difference between being a dominating big personality and a vibrant big personality. Having a vibrant personality will absolutely draw attention to yourself. I'm sure you'll get involved in projects and businesses and new opportunities, but it doesn't mean you're dominating others. As you interact with your big personality, catch yourself if you notice yourself being overly sassy or hurtful with your language. If you notice yourself trying to control others or manipulate others through your vibrancy. Make sure, again, that you're using your big personality to nurture others and welcome others. The big personality woman can be such an asset in our communities, and she should not shy away from her feminine side. Use your skills with people to encourage others and start communities. Use your drive for accomplishing things to bless your family, contribute to your family, and to hone in on your talents. Use your drive to achieve and accomplish things in a positive way by blessing others and putting your skills towards worthwhile tasks and opportunities. Having a big personality is a blessing, and it should never be looked down upon. These women can sometimes seem more masculine if they're focused on dominating others or attention seeking or whatever. Instead of just telling people what to do, telling them what you think, ask people. A great example of this is, instead of telling someone to take out the garbage, ask them to take out the garbage. Instead of telling someone what you think they should do with their life, ask them more about their life and get to know them better. Don't give unsolicited advice. Wait for people to ask for your opinion on things instead of automatically telling it. It's just about learning boundaries, and that's how you can nurture your relationships and hone in on your personality and even probably make more friends. Be mindful of others and respect their boundaries. Ensure that you are doing your best to encourage those around you and inspire others. Women with big personalities can get movements going. They can inspire others and formulate thoughts and get work done. This is all wonderful, but make sure that you use those gifts in a positive way. I also feel like a lot of women with big personalities have been told by society or even their families that they need to use those skills in a career. Don't feel like just because you're good at administration or projects or leadership, it doesn't mean you can't stay at home and be a homemaker or be a traditional stay-at-home mom. Those skills of administration and leadership and intensity can absolutely be used from your home. You can start side businesses or even just focus on your children. You can volunteer, start events in your community, and bless others. Big personalities are absolutely effective in our communities, and honestly, we could probably use a little bit more of them in the home. Remember that God did not create us all the same for a reason. Unique talents, unique gifts are all to be respected. We are different, but we are all valuable, and even women with big personalities can work on honing their strengths in a feminine way to nurture those around them. So if that's you, if you have a big personality, I think that's incredible. Don't be tricked into believing you're automatically masculine, but make sure you're not dominating people around you. I think that there is so much nuance and context with each person involved in their own journey on femininity. My journey towards femininity is not going to look the same as yours necessarily. We are all different, and that's the way God made it. So today, I just hope you feel encouraged and loved in your uniqueness. But that is going to be it for today. So if you liked the video, please click the like button. It does help grow our community, as does subscribing. If you haven't yet, click that subscribe button and join the feminine family. If you're interested in more of this content, please check out my written blog. And as usual, I hope you have a wonderfully blessed and feminine week, my sisters.